that the power handling capacity mainly depends upon two or three important parameters. One is the transmission voltage, okay? Second is the positive sequence reactance, and of course, series compensation, and third is the transmission distance. So among those parameters, the most vital parameter, which has got the highest impact on the power handling capacity is the transmission voltages, standard transmission voltages. Okay. So transmission voltages, power handling capacity is directly proportional to the square of transmission voltages. Okay. So in India, what are the standard transmission voltages that are adopted? And in many cases, these voltages are also in line with the international standards as well for the transmission of AC high voltages. Okay. So we are going to check with the standard transmission voltages. So check that the voltages adopted for the transmission of bulk power. Remember, we are talking about the bulk power. So that is a large amount of power that is generally used for the transmission, isn't it? So the bulk power transmission that takes place, right? Remember that we are talking about the bulk power transmission, okay? Large amount of power. So voltages adopted for transmission of bulk power, they must have certain standard specifications formulated in all the countries and at international level, right? So these are necessary in view of import, export, and domestic manufacture, right? So you should realize here that the standard transmission voltages, standard specifications are formulated and they are common for all the countries, even at international levels. Because we may want to import, we may want to export, okay? We may want to manufacture it or utilize it through various appliances and devices. Naturally, when you buy some circuit or when you buy some device from one country and take it to another country, it must be able to function. It should not be abruptly out of use because these things are not manufactured everywhere. So some countries are leading in these technologies, okay? And consequently, they may be selling it across the world. So there has to be some uniformity. So following voltages levels, they are specified in India as per the Indian this standard IS 2026. Voltage levels for bulk power transmission in India for line-to-line values, okay? Line-to-line values of voltages of 132 kV and higher. So bulk power transmission takes place at what voltage levels? It takes place at voltage levels of 132 kV and higher. Okay. So what are the different transmission voltage levels? So these are defined in two different domains. One is the nominal system voltage, also known as the rated transmission voltage, okay, for the transmission network. And second is the maximum operating voltage, highest value of voltage which the system will be able to carry while handling the power. Okay. So nominal system voltage. Nominal system voltages are rated voltages. They have these different kinds of levels in India: 132 kV, 220 kV, 275 kV, 345 kV, 400 and 500 kV, and then 750 kV. So out of these various transmission voltages, the most common long distance transmission voltage corresponds to 400 kV. Okay. And in Nagpur also, we have got one load dispatch center which receives 400 kV power at one particular center, and then it is distributed throughout the city. So many substation generating stations are connected at this voltage to the load dispatch center on the Amravati Road, present on Amravati Road. Okay. So after 400 kV, there are some three or four 220 kV substations, presently in Nagpur, okay, and then maybe 12 to 15 substations which are 132 kV. So stage wise the distribution takes place from one large transformer to then four major centers and then 10 another sub centers, and then further the voltage level will get reduced up to 11 kV and then 440 volts at the consumer end. So of course we are not interested in voltages below this because we are talking about the transmission. We are talking mainly about the transmission levels. Okay, as I told you, power handling capacity depends upon the transmission voltages. Naturally, when the power to be handled is smaller, we should not use a very large capacity transmission line. That's why these voltage levels exist. If the power transmission, power requirement is lesser in some areas, so at that place, 132 kV will suffice. The design of the transmission lines, tower structure and other dimensions, it leads to savings in the cost. If we don't project that power requirement will increase by a large extent, we don't have 400 kV everywhere. 400 kV is mainly for the connecting the major portion of transmission network carrying bulk power in India. Okay. So these are the voltage levels. Then the next row that is explained here is maximum operating voltage. Maximum operating voltages, if you try to find the ratio here, okay. So 132 kV line will have a maximum operating voltage of 145 kV. Okay, these are also specified as a standard. If I try to take the ratio 145, let us say difference between these two. Okay, so how much is 145 with respect to 132? Okay, if you try to calculate, then it will come out to be around 10 to 11%. Okay, higher. So 145 is 10% higher than 132. So this being the entry level bulk power transmission voltage, so here the difference between maximum operating voltage and nominal system voltage is nearly 10%. Okay, as we move higher up the scale, right, 400 kV, right? So here if you try to calculate, isn't it 400 kV? So you'll realize that the difference between 400 and 420 kV, right? So it is only 5%. 5%, and still higher voltages which are not yet very common in India, 750 and then 765. So this difference may be around 2%, right? So as we move from 132 kV to higher and higher voltages, the margin between nominal system voltage and maximum operating voltage is very, very small. This is keeping in view because as the voltage level increases, the maximum operating voltage decides the level of insulation. And as we move higher and higher, we know that the cost of insulation is directly proportional to the cube of voltage. If we double the voltage, then the cost of insulation may rise by 8 times. So that is why as we move to higher voltage levels, we cannot keep very high margin for insulation. Okay, we can have only marginal increase because maybe the cost is prohibitive as we move towards higher. And here, at higher voltage levels, the switching over voltages are of prime importance, and they govern the insulation coordination and other factors. So standard transmission voltages, they are visible here in India, that are followed. They are standard, okay, as per IS 2026. So now you know that what are the standard transmission voltages, and also you know what is the most common transmission voltage in India, that is a 400 kV. Okay, right. Now we would like to just take a look at the definition of what is a nominal system voltage and what is maximum operating voltage. Okay, so nominal system voltage, you can see from the very first definition here. Okay, nominal system voltage, it is the rated transmission voltage which the system is able to handle under the steady state. It's a rated voltage, okay? So system will be able to carry this voltage indefinitely in service unless and until there is some failure or some disturbance is there in the transmission network, okay? Then the next definition is regarding the maximum operating voltage. These two voltages were reflected in the table, maximum operating voltage. Maximum operating voltage is a voltage specified above in the list, okay, and it should not be exceeded in any part of the system. This is the voltage level it should not be exceeded in any part of the system, because insulation level of all equipments, these are based upon the maximum operating voltages. Okay, so these are the definitions for nominal system voltage used in transmission and the maximum operating voltage. And relation between maximum operating voltage and nominal system voltage varies. It may be up to 10% higher at voltage level of 132 kV, and it will be around 2-3% higher at the voltage level of 765 or 750 kV. Okay, so this is the idea about the transmission voltages. We are talking about power transmission capabilities, right? Let us now move ahead and check with the numerical examples, which are very commonly these are asked in the university exam. Hardly you will find any university papers in the offline format that there is no example on the power handling capacity. So one such simple example I have taken just to help you understand the concept of power handling capacity. Every time you take any examination, and there is a calculation of power handling capacity with respect to one or the other variation values and like that. Okay, so first and foremost, just pay attention that you have to keep your notebooks, pens, calculators ready so that you are going to solve along with me, right? So as you solve this example in your notebooks, today itself in the Google Classroom, you have to make the submission of today's work corresponding to your roll number. I'll be assigning that work. Now this particular submission is a regular assessment, okay, for just to identify whether you are really involved in the classwork or not. I am having a very hard time asking people to submit the assignments and submit the practicals. Okay, in the online mode, some are active, some are maybe they don't know what they have submitted or what is not, right? So it is a good practice. This example is solved here, okay, and you are going to solve along with me in the class right now, and write your name and roll number on top and today's date, and write this as example number one. Okay, kindly note down this question. Okay, I'll just give you just 5 minutes time to note it down. You can just write down this question and maybe also take the screenshot of this, right? Iska screenshot leke rakh lijiye agar likh nahi rahe hai to, lekin problem ka jo hai सोल्यूशन आपको अभी मेरे साथ साथ में सॉल्व करना है. आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू एग्री विथ मी. आर यू रेडी विथ द पेन एंड कैलकुलेटर? राइट, सब लोगों के पास है अभी नोटबुक्स, पेन, कैलकुलेटर, राइट? शैल वी प्रोसीड? सो टेक अ स्क्रीनशॉट एंड सी ए पावर ऑफ 1200 मेगावाट इज रिक्वायर्ड टू बी ट्रांसमिटेड ओवर अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ 1000 किलोमीटर्स. 1200 megawatt is to be transmitted. So it's a huge amount of power, 1200 megawatt. Okay, it's a huge amount of power. It is to be transmitted over a distance of 1000 kilometers. So you can consider we are trying to transmit the power here from Nagpur all the way up to somewhere in Mumbai or so. So distance is like this. Okay, 1000 kilometers at a voltage level of, two different voltage levels are provided here, 400 kV and 750 kV. Right, this is very common determine. So three different elements are involved. Possible number of circuits required with magnitude of sending end and receiving end voltage. Okay, possible number of circuits required with magnitude of sending end and receiving voltage have it a 30 degree phase difference. Okay, so sending end receiving end voltage ke beech mein jo angle hai wo yahan pe diya hai, 30 degree phase difference is there. Okay, secondly, you have to calculate the current to be transmitted, how much current will be transmitted through the lines if I want to supply a power of 1200 megawatt at, let us say, 400 kV or 750 kV. So how much is the current? And lastly, the total line losses. Power loss that is taking place while transmitting this much amount of power at this much voltage level. How much will be the line losses? So we have to calculate 1, 2 and 3 parameters for 400 kV and then for the 750 kV alternative. So in effectively, 3 parameters at 400 kV, 3 parameters at 750 kV, 2 different voltage levels. So you actually, this looks like 3, but you have to make 6 calculations. Okay. So while solving this, some additional information that is very much required in this case is provided along with the question. So generally, this is standard value. At 400 kV, the resistance in ohms per kilometer is 0.031 and positive sequence reactance small x ohms per kilometer is 0.327. Okay, so you can clearly observe here that this line reactance is nearly 100 times the line resistance. That is why we generally neglect this line resistance while making the calculations. Earlier on, we have specified that resistance neglected, only line reactance is considered. Similarly, for 750 kV, the line resistance per kilometer is 0.0136 ohms per kilometer, and corresponding value for positive sequence reactance is 0.272. So these values are provided. Okay. I hope and I request that when I ask you questions, so you be proactive and unmute yourself and answer the questions as I'm asking. Okay. And start solving with me. So these very, very simple examples are there. So first thing is that we would like to solve this particular question at 400 kV first. Okay. And at 400 kV, the first thing that we need to evaluate the number of circuits required for obtaining the transfer of power of 1200 megawatts, right? Number of circuits. So see, some kind of numbering I'm using here A for 400 kV. So generally this 400 kV and 750 kV, they are not given any numbering in the question, but we classify them 400 kV. And within 400 kV, the first part is the number of circuits, right? So how to solve, how to go for it? So first of all, power handling capacity of single circuit line must be evaluated. We want to transfer bulk power, but we must know how much power can be transmitted by one particular line. Okay. So that is already derived earlier as P is equal to E square sine delta upon X into L, right? So for 400 kV transmission line, the value of positive sequence reactance is provided in the table as 0.327 ohms per kilometer, right? And delta is equal to 30 degrees. And delta means phase difference between sending and receiving end voltage. It is specified 30 degrees. And even if it is not specified during the examination, by chance, if the question is not carrying the information, then you can assume this to be 30, it's a standard value. And transmission distance is provided as 1000 kilometers. So you know the voltage, you know the positive sequence reactance, you know delta, you know L, please calculate the value of P. Okay. So as I'm writing here the value of P, at the same time, I request that you please confirm whether this value is coming out to be correct as to 44.648 megawatt. Okay. Next. See, what happens is that we have calculated for single circuit at 400 kV given parameters, so 244.648 megawatt. In many textbook, this value is shown as 245, the approximate rounded up value, close to one decimal place. Okay. So once you know the power that can be transmitted by single circuit, but do you want to transmit 244.648? No. You actually want to transmit a power of 1200 megawatts, right? You want to transmit a power of 1200 megawatt. So naturally, for transmitting 1200 megawatt, a single circuit can transmit only 245 megawatts. But you want to transmit 1200. So what to do? You know the voltage level, you know the capacity of one line, but you want to transfer this much. Naturally, you need to have a number of circuits connected in parallel. So let us calculate the total of number of circuits. This is equal to total power PT divided by P. So 1200 upon 244.648. please evaluate what is the ratio. The ratio will come out to be 4.9 something. Okay, please verify, and if correct, then we'll proceed. Okay, RIA 4.9.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Right. Okay. So the ratio of RIA approximately is the 4.9. So, but please remember that this 4.9 is not an integer number. जैसे कि मैंने आपको बताया कि एक एग्जांपल मैंने आपको दिया था कि अगर तीन लोगों को बाइक से ट्रैवल करना है, एक बाइक पे दो लोग जा सकते हैं, तो हम लोग डेढ़ बाइक यूज नहीं कर सकते हैं, दो बाइक यूज करनी पड़ेगी. वही एक रीजन है कि नंबर ऑफ सर्किट कैन नॉट बी अ फ्रैक्शन. यू हैव टू पुट अ न्यू सर्किट. सो 0.9 सर्किट मीन्स नथिंग. यू हैव टू मेक इट 5, राइट? सो लेट अस नाउ जस्ट चेक विद द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड, राइट? So that's why we can say the number of circuit has to be the integer number, right? Number of circuit has to be integer number. 4.9, it is always taken as a higher integer, right? So n is equal to approximately equal to 5, integer number. So if you are not supplying circuit using this total power by using 4.9 circuits, right, you are actually supplying the power through 5 circuits. So therefore the actual power that will be handled by each of the circuit has to be recalculated. It has to be recalculated because you are not using 4.9 circuits, you are actually using 5 circuits. So the assumption here is that when 5 circuits are put in place, each circuit will be carrying equal amount of power. So what is that equal amount of power? It's not 4.9, you are using 5. So back calculation has to be done, that total power divided by the number of integer number of circuits, so PT upon 5. Okay, that's why the actual power that is being handled by each of the circuit is not 244. You are using slightly higher number for n. So that's why the actual power handled per circuit will be 240 megawatts. I hope this particular step is clear to all of you, right? Now, next we move ahead further and try to calculate the current that can be transmitted for supplying a bulk power of 1200 megawatt. So current calculations are very, very simple. Three phase current can be calculated as root 3 VLIL equal to power, right? Active power. So this is line current. I is equal to P upon root 3 times of E. Please remember that this is now actual power because we are using integer number of circuits. So each circuit will carry equal amount of power of 240 megawatt. So that's why we substitute here 240 megawatts, not 244, because N is 5 for us. Okay. So P actual 240 divided by root 3 times of 400. 400 is the rated voltage for this particular set of calculation. Here you have to understand that power, what is the unit for power? Yes, what is the unit for power? It is in megawatt, isn't it? So 10 raised to 6. And what is the unit for voltage? Kilovolts, isn't it? This is in mega and this is in kilo. So that's why the result is in kilo. Okay, so here I have not... See, when the power is in megawatt, voltage is in kilovolts, so current will be in kiloampere. Kilo multiplied by kilo will give you mega. 10 raised to 3 is equal to 10 raised to 6. Okay. You need not write here. Directly calculate 240 by root 3 into 400 and the result should be mentioned as a kiloampere. Okay. Agar confusion hai, to 10 raised to 6 lagao, phir yahan pe 10 raised to 3 lagao, phir baad mein isko kiloampere ya ampere mein express karo. No problem. Okay. So you get this particular value of current as 0.346 kiloampere. Remember that we have substituted here the power actually carried by per circuit. That means one circuit power handling capacity is 240, corresponding voltage 400. So the current per circuit, remember, first we are calculating current per circuit, 0.346 kiloampere. Okay. But this is not the total current. What is the total current? It is to be calculated. Total current will be equal to IT is equal to N multiplied by I. N means number of circuits. We don't have one circuit. We have five circuits. So 5 multiplied by current per circuit. So it gives us the total current as equal to 1.73 kiloampere. This I have made the calculation. Okay, of course, now this one is 0.346 into 5. You can just verify that one, that power is equal to 1.73 kiloampere. Okay, I hope this till this point, the calculations and everything is clear to all of you, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so very simple one. These are power calculations. This you study right from the first year. So, yeah. But then this is application to high voltage transmission. Okay, I'll move to the next slide. So we have calculated number of circuits here, and we have calculated the current to be transmitted. Third thing is we want to calculate the power loss, right? Third thing that we would like to calculate is the total line losses. How much line losses will be there? Here, of course, the assumption again comes into picture that we are not accounting for the corona power loss. We are only taking into account I square R loss, right? So line losses per circuit. Again, please note, we first make all the calculation on per circuit basis. Power loss is equal to I square into R, I square R for one circuit, or you may consider one line. So there are generally for a three-phase circuit, three lines are there. So that's why three times I square capital R. Capital R is actually resistance per kilometer multiplied by so many kilometers. Okay, so this is 3 I square R. L is coming because this parameter is in per kilometer basis, and this is the total distance. So total power loss for a single circuit line. So naturally there will be three lines for R, Y and B. So three lines, three phase lines are there. 3 into I square R L. Please remember that the value of resistance is also provided at 400 kV. This R is equal to 0.031 ohms per kilometer, right? And current, we have calculated it just now. This current per circuit, remember, current here is not IT, here I square. Okay, so I 0.346 kiloampere, right? So please do the calculation for the power loss as equal to 3 times 0.346 square. Okay, so I am directly substituting this in kiloampere. So square of kiloampere, this will come into megawatts, multiplied by 0.031 multiplied by the distance, right? So we come across the power loss per circuit as equal to 11.133 megawatt. And also please remember that see, in the online mode now, as we are making these calculations, so agar aapko objective type ke question deta hu, to ye is lambe example mein se main kahin par aapko current de dunga aur resistance de dunga, power aapko nikalna hai, ya fir power de diya maine, current de diya, to resistance calculate karna hai. This way, these small calculations might be asked in the objective type of questions. Okay, but in the broader sense, we have to understand the whole concept, right? Let us now see that this is the line losses per circuit, but this is not the only circuit that we are using. We have told earlier also that we are actually having n number of circuits, so 5 circuits, isn't it? So total power loss, PTL, this notation I am using, n times of PL. So you substitute PL from here, 5 times of this. So it will be very easy to just check that if this is 11.11, okay. So 5 times of this is 55.667 so megawatt. This is total power loss, line losses that are taking place. Got it? So this way, the 50% of this particular numerical example has been solved. We have solved for voltage level of 400 kV. But same power has to be transmitted by using 750 kV transmission line as well. And then we have to check what is the difference. Okay. So just pay attention that this is 55.667 megawatt, right? This is the total power loss. And how much is the total power that we are transmitting? Total power we are transmitting is 1200 megawatt. Okay. So can somebody calculate, although it is not required here, can somebody calculate what is 55.66 divided by 1200 megawatt? How much percentage it is? 55.66 divided by 1200 multiply this ratio multiplied by 100. How much percentage it is? So 4.638. That means the percentage power loss, if you are supposed to calculate percentage power loss, it will be total loss upon total power transmitted. It is coming out to be less than 5%. So this is quite an efficient system, that power transmission over a distance of 1000 kilometers at 400 kV with 5 circuits. Only 5% power loss. Very, very efficient. 95% efficiency of power transmission. This is just an idea. Okay. So let us now move ahead and repeat these calculations for a voltage level of 750 kV. So all of you pay attention that now we are coming across the calculation for the voltage level of 750 kV. And first, we would like to calculate the number of circuits. So for calculating the number of circuits, we must know the power handling capacity of single circuit line. Equation is same, E square sine delta by XL. Here now E will be equal to 750 kV. Corresponding positive sequence reactance is now 0.272 ohms per kilometer as given in the problem. Delta is a common value, 30 degrees. Distance of transmission is common, 1000 kilometers. Only voltage and corresponding line reactance will change. We make a substitution and calculate. The value comes out to be 1034 megawatt, right? It is as per the calculation that is I have done. You may check with your right calculation here. Aapko karna hai. So I'll just go through this particular part so that just it will help you verify your values. Jo log kar rahe calculation wo dekh sakte hain, aur nahi to fir sham mein calculation karke submit karna hai. Theek hai. Next is the total power. To transfer total power of 1200 megawatt, while one can transfer a power of 1000. Okay, so 1200 divided by 1000 will give you number of circuit it comes out to be. If again a fractional number higher than 1.16, so it is 15% higher than single circuit. Naturally, the question will come to our mind whether we should take this as 1 or we should take this as 2, right? So you must understand that power handling capacity is limited. If you want to transfer even 5% extra power, it will not be possible with this. Okay, it will overload the line and it will not be able to supply from one circuit. You have to take the next higher integer multiple, right? So the integer multiple that is taken, it will be equal to n equal to 2 here, 1.16, 15% extra power. We cannot manage with a single circuit. The power handling capacity is limited. We take the higher integer number next. Okay, even if I get 1.1, I'll stick to two circuits. And since two circuits are much higher than 1.16, so naturally the actual power that will be handled per circuit can be recalculated as Pt upon n 1200 by 2. So you can see it will not be 1064 megawatt. Rather, if we consider these to be carrying equal amount of power, if two circuits are there, 600 megawatt each. Right, so then we move ahead and repeat the calculation for current transmitted. It's again P by root 3 E. Substitute the actual power, not the power handling capacity calculated earlier. 600 divided by root 3 times of 750 will come out to be 0.461 kiloamperes. Right, and then the total current transmitted. Number of circuits are not one, rather they are two. So two multiplied by this value of current, this will provide us the total current that is being transmitted for transferring a power of 1200 megawatt over two circuits. So these are a repetition of the calculation for 750 kV, right? We move ahead to the calculation of total line losses. Again, total line losses, they can be calculated by calculating the line losses per circuit as PL is equal to 3 times of I square RL. This is per circuit, 3 phase line and then I square R. Okay. In this case, the value of R is 0.0136 ohms per kilometer for 750 kV. And current you have already calculated for single circuit to be equal to 0.461 kiloamperes. Substituting single circuit current and the resistance per kilometer and the value of transmission distance, we can get this power transmission, power losses for a single circuit line at 8.67 megawatts, right? And number of circuits are 2, so we have to multiply by 2 in order to get the total power loss, PTL. So you can see there's a significantly lower amount of power loss is taking place at 750 kV voltage. Only 17.341 for the same amount of total power that is to be transmitted, right? That is 1200 megawatt. If you try to take the ratio of this, right? So this percentage power loss will come out to be around 1.5% only. So percentage power loss for 400 kV, it was approximately 5%, and now this is coming out to be 1.5%. So it is quite remarkable that as we move to higher and higher voltage levels, the percentage power loss will be significantly reduced for the same amount of total power to be transmitted.